Last month, the Recording Academy hit Washington, D.C. for their annual Grammys on the Hill event to engage legislators and artists in important conversations regarding the experience of music creators throughout the industry. Along with those conversations, the Academy honored Pharrell, Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer, and Senator Bill Cassidy for their contributions to a more supported environment for music creation. To get an inside look at the four-day event, we caught up with Victoria Monet, Gayle, and Tobe Nwigwe to talk through their experience at the nation's capital, advocating for themselves and their peers. GRAMMYs on the Hill Advocacy Day brought past nominees and winners to DC to connect with members of Congress and share their experiences as creators. Amongst the several issues presented and discussions had, a few pieces of legislation were highlighted as responses to various corners of the industry. The HITS Act supports songwriters, allowing an artist or songwriter to fully expense the cost of new studio recordings on their taxes up to $150,000. Singer and songwriter Victoria Monet has penned tracks for artists like Ariana Grande and Fifth Harmony. Songwriters are often the least protected contributor in the process of making music, with Victoria saying, "The songwriter, in my opinion, is one of the most disrespected and underappreciated groups of people in all of music. I'm dedicated to making that change while I'm here." And the lack of legislation supporting music creation disproportionately affects those who are independent artists. Monet expressed that the tax breaks under the HITS Act would have helped her in sustaining her income and investing long-term. Congress was also called to reform the live event ticketing marketplace to better protect artists and fans and establish a performance right for artists on AM and FM radio. Rising pop singer Gayle advocated strongly for more legislation surrounding live ticketing. She embarked on her first headlining tour in 2022 and was shocked by the reality of ticket scalping, saying, "I was trying to worry about people buying tickets, not buying the tickets to upcharge them up to $800 for a $25 ticket. It was absolutely devastating to me." This year, Gayle is opening up for pop superstar Taylor Swift and has become even more acquainted with the severity of issues surrounding the ticketing industry. The Eras Tour ticketing process saw fans fight back against monopolies like Ticketmaster, and Gayle's experience in DC has moved her to use her platform to raise awareness and make a difference for artists and fans alike. One of the buzziest topics on the Hill was the reintroduction of the Rap Act, which is aimed at limiting the usage of rap lyrics as evidence in court and protecting freedom of speech. Houston rapper Tobe Nwigwe weaves reflections of his experience as a black man in his music, and he maintains that freedom of expression stays protected, saying, "I feel like there's a lot of music that I don't necessarily stay in alignment with, but I feel like I respect. Because we are in America, and that's what is special about this land. We're supposed to have the right to be able to say what it is that we want to say and express how it is that we feel whenever we want to do it. But it just seems like they're trying to figure out a way slowly but surely to try and thwart that." It wasn't just all work in Washington, D.C. Tobe created an original track to honor the contributions of the multi-hyphenate artist Pharrell Williams. Tobe said, "I feel like we stand on Pharrell's shoulders and all the energy that he's put towards making sure artists have what they need to express themselves. I feel like we all benefit from the moves that he's making. And I feel like that's one of the things that he has in mind as he's doing stuff. This shows that he cares about the generations after." As they honored past contributions of artists and advocators, the night was also an opportunity to look toward the future of the industry for music creators. Victoria Monet said it best.
"I think anytime I can advocate for positive change, I'm for it. Especially after having a little one, I feel like the future feels even more important to me. Because if I'm not here, she's here. So it's really super important to just keep pushing forward and not be so cyclical with music when everything else is so progressive. It's 2023, you know. Let's make some positive changes."
I'm Delisa Shannon with Rolling Stone News.